The idea of the gig in the desert was probably one of the first things that came together for the whole thing. We actually set up the gig out here in the Joshua Tree and thought of the name, built the system with all the modules and the, you know, the synths. And we did all that before we even thought about the music.
All the way through, even when we were sat in Hackney writing this stuff and trying to figure out how the sequencer worked, we knew that it was going to the desert.
Favourite electronic records have an obvious human element to them. You know, you can hear, you know, the human behind the machine, and doing the live show, that's where we kind of experienced that the most, and we wanted to incorporate that as much as we could into the record, so it seemed like a good idea to make the recording process and the live process meet directly in the middle. The modular stuff at the minute, in that Eurorap world, has kind of developed quite a momentum. There's a lot of interesting guys around the world who are putting lots of time and energy into designing these strange, esoteric things that have completely their own functionality and their own personality, and you have an idea and you run it through this thing, and more often than not, something better than what you expected to do comes out of it.
There's so many live shows that effectively are a handful of stems. And you spend ages on each individual sound in the studio. And it's something that we've always tried to keep as far away from as possible. Because it just seems like such a complete waste of time. You know? I mean, honestly, you know, you travel to get somewhere, and effectively you just stood there. It's more or less boring. This, I think, is about as close to the antithesis as that as you can get.
Shall I start?
Yeah, go for it.
This is my synth, which is making all of my sounds. Basically, all of these are individual modules that you buy and you assemble them how you want, and you connect them together with all the cables. Drum module.
This is like a wavetable synth.
This envelope shapes the sound.
They're not synchronized in any way other than time.
Changing the way the filter reacts.
There's like a delay.
Maths.
Cross modulation,
Rubicon oscillator,
weird bell noises,
asynchronous gates,
boom cheeky boxes,
LFOs.
James's is very kind of like warm and dreamy and analog, and mine is sort of like gritty and shit.
So yeah, you can get some kind of bunkers and all sort of that.
This is as good as our studio at home, just smaller. You can put it in pallet cases and drag it out into the desert like we were doing yesterday.
We're about to have our chakras healed in a sound bath.
Is this a coil or are they individual rings?
I think it was originally created to communicate with aliens.
What lots of people think is that this voltage would be made, it was a primary energy device, so there was no electricity. And then that some sort of a waveform would go into the parabola upstairs and then somehow be shaped in this cup of coiling, which was meant to be a 90-degree antenna field. And what George claimed was that people could walk through that field and that, you know, essentially their geometry would be reset.
What are these things?
Well, I'll show you what those are.
Thank you.
expected that at all.
It's a mystery, and obviously it's born of complete obsession. And I think to a certain extent that carries back to like the inventor thing, you know, like with the synth modules and all that stuff. Like these people are like, they're creative people that are inventing something, and he's had no help with it. You know, it's a genuine invention.
Recording it tonight, and it's going to be the album. It's quite nerve-wracking because we've kind of put a lot onto this one particular performance, but the fact that it's focused on this one moment has really defined the whole process and the whole album. We've had to learn how to pare down this system so it's as lean and practical as it can be to make a whole song with, you know, live. There's no playback, there's no pre-recorded beats. Every sound on the album will be made from these two boxes. We're going to take that home and mix that and kind of make the album out of it.
I think some people have seen it as like a kind of put 'em up, no hands situation, where it's not just that we're making an album, we're making an album all at once. That the purpose of doing this show was not to make it more difficult, it was to actually to make it better. The second thing it'll do is it gives you that red light fever that you just can't get in the studio. So hopefully that will fill up some new things.
To have a very specific event that you can visualise and what it's going to be like, and you're making music for this event, it was really fun and kind of inspiring for us to kind of like, well, let's make music that is going to fit in this space. It's kind of like bespoke. Pretty big believers in like rolling with whatever's happening, and you know, waiting for something that we both feel is interesting to happen, and then recognizing that moment. You know, I think that's an easier way of approaching it rather than setting out from the beginning like, we're definitely going to do this and we're definitely going to do that. You know, in our experience, whenever we try to do something, we can't do it, you know. And also you bring in a very like rational part of your brain and you're trying to second guess things. I think if you just let it happen, it becomes much more kind of natural and honest to your, you know, your actual intention.